It's time for the 29th annual MSBL World Series Play of the Game. And it's brought to you by Marucci. Honor the game. So two out, the tying run at third base. The championship winning run at second here in the bottom of the ninth inning as Williams delivers. And it's swung on and a fly ball to center field. Antone Henley is back. He's got it. And the 2016 60 and over Mountain Division Championship belongs to the Dallas-Fort Worth Phillies. They hold on and win and come from behind fashion 7-6.
All right, with me now, Antone Henley. 3 weeks here in sunny Arizona, and the last play of the game ends up in your leather. You got a national title here on the final day of the tournament. Talk about the character of this team. I mean, you guys were down 6-5, two out, and then you come up, you get a two-out single to get that eighth inning going. And then, of course, Gary Firestone comes through with a two-run hit.
Oh, yeah, that I enjoyed. I have played ball with and against Firestone for years on his former Aqua Ducey Reds and now Waikiki Boys. Good team, good player, and he really came through.
He certainly did. I guess you can't say enough about Williams, and even Figueroa pitched a good game here today.
Oh, yeah,
but Williams really came through in the clutch.
Yeah, Williams, I can see why he was MVP. He did everything. Pitch, caught, played a little shortstop. We had him do everything under the planet. The man really gave his all. I guarantee you he's in some pain, but he gave his all.
Gary Firestone, the big two-run hit in the eighth inning. Walk us through that at bat. He got ahead of you. Clutch two out or two strike base hit.
He got ahead with breaking balls and tried to come up in the zone with fastballs and tried to stay away from me all day. But after fouling off all those breaking balls up, I just figured he was going to come down, and he did. And he came down over the plate, and I didn't miss it. And that was the biggest at bat of the week for me. So,
talk about this 3 week experience for you. Actually, it's been longer than that.
Yeah, I've been here 4 weeks. This is my fifth ring. Every team I've been on has won. It's never happened to me before. I don't know who it's happened to, but this first time for me. But a long time away from my family. This has made it worth it, and I'm going to give each of them a ring when I get home. I got three kids and a wife and a dog. They're each going to get a ring.
Even the dog's going to get one.
Put it on his collar this year.
Gary, thank you very much.
You got it. Thank you.
Congratulations. Angel Almo, the most valuable player. You share it with Wayne Williams. Congratulations. Your feelings on a great win here today over the Tribe.
Buena jugada, y esto se repartió el MVP con Dwayne Williams y de valioso. Jugador más valioso. Oh, in English? In Spanish?
Thank you, sir.
How do you feel?
¿Cómo se siente?
Me siento muy, muy contento.
Very good feeling, real happy.
Es la tercera vez que compartimos con Wayne Williams, jugador más valioso.
Okay. Y es la tercera. It's the third time that he gets MVP with Dwayne Williams on the championship game.
Fantastic. And ask him, talk about the defense that this team played. A couple of plays got us in trouble, but then it was the defense that came through in the end, I thought.
Yeah, que le digo un poco cómo fue la defensiva, que tuvimos dificultades por un rato, pero ¿cómo cree que la defensa?
No, la defensa estuvo muy bien. Hizo un tiro malo a primera base, pero todo estaba bien.
Yeah, the defense was okay. We made a few errors and a bad throw to first base, but he made up for it. And all those other double plays that he made, and exciting plays, you know.
Okay, thank you very much. Congratulations. All right, Cedric Watson, congratulations. Big 7-6 victory over a tough team here today. Your feelings on winning a national title?
Well, first of all, I want to give honor to God. That's the first person. Second of all, I'd like to give honor to Steve Sigler for allowing this to happen since I've been attending since 88. It's been a blessing. The man has put together a great program, not only for us, the youth as well. And I just want to thank him as well. okay, and the league and all the different countries that started out and different states and things like that, and coaches and staff, umpires, you know, fans that enjoy a good time coming out in Arizona here. Thank the mayor. You know what I mean? Uh-huh. For allowing all these grounds to be taken care of and us to play on them. I just want to thank the other team as well. The Tribe, they play well. A couple of friends of mine was on that team. They do very well. But most of all, my teammates, I give honor to them today for being a winner. We take it humbly, and we really enjoy coming out here every year. I know I do. You know, so it's been great. Great tournament. Gary Firestone, I couldn't ask for nothing more. Nothing more, you know. Been with him for 28 years. Every team. And we've just been putting it together. But this one right here is for Frank Phillips. They believed in me, asked me to come play with them, and we didn't have enough 60s to play on our home team back from Los Angeles, but it's been great. And I just want to thank God again to a great baseball program he has here. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wayne, and not to get real sappy about it, but you're really an inspiration. You're 62 years old. You're out here playing guts and glory. You're playing Pete Rose-style baseball. And the play in which you had to retrieve a wild pitch or pass ball, I'm not sure what it was, you were injured. You went into the backstop here, the barrier behind home plate, and just it seemed like a few minutes later you're out on the pitcher's mound. What was going on through your mind during that time?
Well, I grew up playing in pro ball. That says I played with Pete Rose, and there's only one way to play. When you're on the field, if it ain't broke, you play ball.